Hi there.
In this video, we'll be talking about the wonders of conditional text in InDesign. So let's get started. I have a few sentences typed in here, and you could see that every sentence has the American as well as the UK spelling of the words. Basically, instead of two completely different sets of sentences, I'd like to have just one version. And using the conditional text, I can switch between the two versions. Let's go to Window, and then Type and Tables, and select Conditional Text. In the pop-up menu, you can see that at this point, the entire text is set to unconditional. So let's select the American spelling of the word color, and then click the small plus button at the bottom of the Conditional Text panel. Let's rename it US Spelling. And there are other settings you can play with, so you can have it underlined or highlighted. So let's keep it underlined for this one. You can even set the appearance of the chosen method from wavy, solid, or dashed. So let's keep it wavy. And lastly, you can set the color of the indicator from a wide variety of available colors and then hit OK. Since the conditional text is set, let's highlight the word color and click the new conditional text we've just created. And you shall find the blue wavy underline appearing below the word. Similarly, select the word flavor and set it as US spelling. Likewise, do it for the rest of the American spellings in all the sentences. Each time you set a word to the American spelling, a blue underline should appear below it. Now highlight the UK spelling of the word color and click the small plus button at the bottom of the conditional text panel and rename it UK spelling. Let's change the appearance to dashed and hit OK. Now with the word selected, select the UK spelling conditional text. Much like earlier, select all the UK spellings and assign them to the UK spelling conditional text. Now comes the best part. Suppose I want to print the sentences with the UK spelling only, so all I need to do is click the eye icon next to the US spelling to turn the visibility off. And it shall show me the sentences with just the UK spelling. Similarly, if I want the sentences with just the US spellings, I'm going to turn it on and turn the UK spelling off, and job's done. You can even choose to hide the indicators from the drop-down menu should you want to. So it's a very nice feature, particularly when you have two or more variations of the same thing like shoe sizes or spellings or measurements, etc. So do make good use of it. All right, guys, that concludes our session and I'm going to see you in just a bit. Goodbye.